and sparkles. A beautiful. How's Polly? Is Polly good? Is Polly good? Do I need to check on him?
Why, hello, sucker. No, I'm kidding. They're like the best catfish around.
They're mean, though. That one got pretty big, pretty quick. I see you, Polly. I seen you. Polly boy. Polly, want a cracker?
He's hiding behind his weeds.
Polly, can I see you?
What's up, Polly?
Polly the true parrot fish from Brazil. Look at the beak on that.
Dude, their mouth opens like that wide, which is crazy. I've seen him eat minnows before, it's funny. But he's more of a vegetarian. Now, Sparkles, on the other hand, she will eat your finner. Sparkles, quit eating fingers. No fingers for you. Sparkles, right here. Right here. No, we don't need to be looking up. What you want? Look at that tooth. I see your hook tooth. That sucker. Hey, hey, that's a hook. You see that hook tooth? That's a hook underneath there, and when she grabs her food, she grips it with that hook. Although she's got millions of other serrated teeth. Why are you always poking your head out of the water? Says so I can safely get my stuff. Right? Right, baby? Right, baby? That's my hand. You saw it. It's my hand. Oh my god! Really? Ah! What? Jerry, watch out! Clean up on aisle 4! God dang it. Watch out, Joey. I'll hook it up. There you go. Safe crossings for the kitty. Alright, Sparkles, you got me soaked. Jerk.
That's a big pleco, sir.
That is a big pleco, sir.
Georgia, Georgia on my mind. Baby girl. Baby girl. Morning. I petted you.
Sparkles is a jerk. Always wanting food. Doesn't want nothing but food, so she's mean.
Predators. Watch my predator. I forget I always have that there to block out the sunlight on the other side.
Guess you don't notice, because when you're looking in front, you know, you don't see that stuff. Yeah. Kids, what are you doing? Are you just trying to cause a bunch of riffraff?
Georgia. Georgia. Georgia on my mind. Jerry me mutes. Hey, come here, geekies. Me mutes. Me, me mutes. Me, me mutes.
So the pump on this side, I lost power last week and it broke on me. That was the Tetra pump. The Walmart ones are in the water already. The motor is inside the water. So that one restarted just fine. As far as all the Walmart heaters, they've all lasted me over the past 4 years. And what I'm getting ready to do is, and I'm pretty positive on this, because that pump broke, these guys have been causing some riffraff out here because the flow is only on one side. So what I think I'm gonna have to do is, I'm going to take the breeding pair of green terrors back here, because they've did nothing but lay eggs the past couple years and caused this crazy algae for me to clean up, the black beard hair algae, and it is a pain in the butt. But when you look around, there's millions of baby fish. I mean, there's adult fish. There's, it's hard to tell, but they just laid another batch. Oh, she brought them inside the hut this time. That's kind of smart of her. I don't know, maybe I might even separate the male and female so that the breeding just stops, because I can't get in there to clean this algae. No matter what I try to use or do, it comes back the next day really fast. It's best to just leave it in there after they first lay their babies or have their babies, because then you get all these little, I don't know if you can even see that, but there's tons of babies down there. They're just cruising the bottom and feeding on that black-beater hair algae. Oh, okay, I see some here in the corner. There you go. See them? So, I mean, they're all over the tank. There's part sand in here. There's part sand, part used. Whoa, lost my screen. Focus. There we go. That'll work. I just pressed back. Look how big my GT is, though. He's freaking huge. My big papa GT. Even got the camera zoomed out and he's being a little wimp. What's the matter, GT? It's because it's awfully bright, huh? But today I'm supposed to do filters and stuff. Well, honestly, I thought I had this set up for the babies. I was going to pull the babies, use them to feed my fish and keep the cycle going. But honestly, that is a pain in the butt. And very tough to do, because you gotta literally get a bigger tank to be, like this, to build the babies up. So maybe I'll set this one up later and start raising fry in it together. Like millions of the Severems together and millions of the green terrors together. And then power feed them is what they call it, where you make sure you're feeding them. It's kind of overfeeding, but I only feed these guys every other day a little pinch. And that's how it became. As soon as winter starts, that's how I do it. If not every day, every 3 days. It's like a plant. Like these ones. I tried to water these ones, and these are not plants that survive the winter. So it doesn't matter how much you water them sometimes or feed them. You're just pretty much putting more worms and detritus in your tank. Like this plant right here didn't get watered much at all. And you could already see where it's overwatered from the curling here. It's crazy. And this plant came back and died like 3 times. But you can see new leaves now that I haven't been watering these. They're just sucking up all the nutrients. These mother-in-law's tongues, they're like almost impossible to kill. So that's what I'm going to be doing on the fish tank work. Because as you can see, fall has set in. We got snow on Halloween and we're probably going to get some more here soon. So the sooner I get this done, I can clean it. Set up a good pump on it. Nice and clean and a nice set of lights, and I'm sure somebody will buy this because it's got the aftermarket lids on it, and they're pretty handy if you want to put your own style of light on there that changes colors on timers. People love that stuff. When I first got into rescuing cichlids, I used to take everything and try to recreate their wild habitat, and I started to realize that was dumb, because no matter how hard I tried, they would destroy my plants. Cichlids don't really enjoy the plants, especially when they bring all kinds of extra detritus worms, snails, diseases, even something simple as like adding fertilizer to your water or whatever, or something to suck up that fertilizer is hard sometimes, because now you're just creating something that wants more fertilizer. And unless you have more fish and more, that's why those ecosystems are so big. Like the pond is easy for me to keep, but the little tanks are very hard to maintain. Because as soon as one little thing goes wrong, it's like everything goes wrong. So I think I'm gonna move them out here to this one. This one's a 75. I'll take the Severums and they'll either go into the pond. Jerry, what are you doing? Good day. Thank you. He's trying to catch the catfish. Get her whiskers. He's already got him a couple times. You can tell. But that's just what they do, I guess. They coexist. God, you're big. I don't think people realize how big this thing is in my home, man. The tank itself isn't that big. I was zoomed in or zoomed out, but this is a 90 gallon. A lot of people think this is 100. It's only 90 gallons. So you got 90 gallons here, 150 gallons here, But even at 150 gallons, she's already bigger than the size of it. So she already outgrew it. Now it's just a matter of finding a bigger home like Ohio Fish Rescue. I know, I feel you. You loving on me? You were on the tank. It's okay. Just don't do it all the time, buddy. What's up, baby girl? See your tail? She just uses her tail to guide the bottom now. And these guys, like, I don't get how the algae stays so under control when they're right in front of a dang window, man. Like, I know she eats quite, the plecos usually stop eating the algae around this size. So just the fact that it's eating algae, probably because I ran out of pellets for a while, maybe. She just really depended on that algae. How you doing, buddy? You're not the shy one, huh? You're the mean one. There, I got two different ones. One's a really shy one. When they get big like this one down here, this one's my, I wear a size 14 and it's bigger than my feet, so it's almost 2 feet. And that one is actually a pellet eater. It does not even like any algae. That's why she's sitting down there between that rock, sleeping during the day. She'll be out all night. She won't touch this algae that's on the side. I don't know if I can. There you go. Now you can see the algae. There is algae on the walls there, but it kind of works itself out. Cat left prints on my tank. Dang it. Cause I'm just a teenage dirtbag, baby. Just a teenage dirtbag, baby. Now I gotta clean this up and get ready for practice. Speaking of music, I gotta get ready for practice. I gotta clean your mess. Ugh. I take it you want a bite. That's probably why she's all flustered. She wants a bite. Dang it. It's hard to do things one-handed. What's up, baby girl? If I stay here with my hands, she'll just sit there. Alright, I'll give you a bite. He doesn't know who I am. And he doesn't give a damn about me. Cause I'm just a teenage mew, 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 mew. Listen to Iron Maiden, maybe with me. Ooh, ooh. Yeah. One-handed. Hold on. Yeah, she doesn't know what she's missing. Yeah. Dirtbag. Alright, those are alright, chunkies. You want something? We're coming over here, though. I'm not doing that shit where you splash me. We're coming to the edge. Start with a little chunky. Pork chop a chunky. You're with too fast for yourself, okay? That's when you know you got issues. Quit. Calm down. Swallow. You better swallow it. All right. She's got that ornery look like she might not eat it. Baby girl, you ready for another piece? Yeah? You did it again. What are you splashing the... Look, she's got this slosh buckle in here. Don't ever try to keep a peacock bass in a tank this small either. It's a death sentence. I'm just very ruthless with my pets and ran out of space and money. The rescue turned into me asking for help. I'll be asking for help now. And nobody will come pick them up. Not with guarantee that the fish will live. A lot of them just want the tanks, which I get and I understand, but at the same time, I care about these animals. I did raise them. They are animals. Fish do have feelings. Don't care what anyone says, they do have freaking feelings. They feel that hook. They just don't care. It's hungry.